we've just come out of the York Dungeon and I'm here with Ben once again, the marketing manager of York Dungeon. Ben, it's lovely to see you again.
Yeah, lovely to see you as well.
Can't believe it's been a year since we were last here talking about the cast of the Witch on the opening day. Can't believe it's been a year.
It's flown by, absolutely flown by. There's been that much going on. We've got so much going on this year as well.
Absolutely, and I can't wait to find out more. So just talking about the War of the Roses then, what sort of led to the decision to bring in the War of the Roses in the Golden Fleece scene?
Well, it's an iconic part of history, and you know, one of the primary focuses of the conflict was here in York, because it's House of York and the House of Lancaster. And we decided that we wanted to look for a story outside of York. Because every story that we've got so far, they're all within the city. We wanted to branch out a little bit, and the story of the Battle of Towton really struck us as something that was significant, was incredibly important, was very gory and violent, which ticks all the boxes for us, but also is not necessarily as well known.
Yeah.
And that's one thing that we like to do, is we like to sometimes talk about some of the stories that aren't as well known. Like Isabella Billington with Curse of the Witch.
Yes.
To bring the understanding and to bring that knowledge to a wider audience while giving them a great time and entertaining them.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So how did you sort of piece it all together? How did you sort of bring it all together? Was it just a simple just telling of the actors and changing of the script, or was it a bit more than that?
Well, the performance team and the displays team do a lot of research into the time that these stories are set and who the people were at that time. So they really, really put in that work to make everything as authentic as possible.
Yeah.
Once you get the authentic stuff, then you can add the dungeon stuff onto it.
Yeah.
I think if we did it the other way around, it wouldn't be as legitimate.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want people to walk out thinking that was fine, but I don't believe it. Whereas if they walk out saying, oh, that was something that happened, but we saw it in a slightly different, scary, fun way.
Yeah.
Once we've done that, then all the research is done, then the script is written. The script is then, you know, passed around a few people just to make sure that it hits all the dungeon tick boxes. And then once it's signed off, we then send it out to the actors. And then we start the rehearsal process. And it's quite an intense rehearsal process. But we get everybody signed off very, very quickly on it. And just the way that the performance team, they're so good at what they do, you know, they'll take these actors, they'll give them the script, and then they come in and they know it all. It's just a case of, right, can we find where the buttons are? Can we make sure that we've got it all set? But everybody who does it for the public has been signed off quite recently. And I mean, I don't know what you think, but when I see that show, I think it looks like they've been doing it for years because they know it so well.
Absolutely, it's really brilliant. And am I right in saying this is a seasonal thing? This is not a permanent show?
Yeah, as it stands, and I always say as it stands because with dungeons, you never know. Sometimes we just like throw in a little bit of a surprise. As it stands, we're running it for 2 weeks.
Okay.
It'll be from today, February 15th, all the way through to February 29th. I then we'll see what's happening going forward, but this is the first of three shows that we're going to be doing this year.
Fantastic. So is there anything you can tell us about anything else that's coming for the 2020 season?
Absolutely. So in May we're going to be doing another show launch, and that's going to be our big permanent show launch, and it will revolve around Guy Fawkes. I'm not going to say any more on it at all, but it will be to do with Guy Fawkes. And then around Halloween, we're going to be taking a slightly different track with Halloween this year.
Okay.
Last year, we were the home of Halloween. This year, we are still going to be the place to come for Halloween and the home of Halloween, but we're going to be focusing a little bit more on some of the spirits of York.
Okay, so
we are going to be having, well, at the moment, I'd say we have Curse of the Witch as our terrifying show.
Yeah.
All the other scary fun things, which are terrifying. At Halloween, we'll have two terrifying shows in the dungeon. Yeah.
Very interesting. So with the, obviously you can't say more about the Guy Fawkes show coming in May, but am I right in saying this replacing the Talking Heads, or is this going to be an extension?
You might think that, I couldn't possibly comment.
Oh! Because I know I said it earlier, I need to watch out for a show that might look like it might be going. I don't know if the Talking Heads looked like it was going, I thought it was all running well.
It is, but with what we like to do is we always like to keep things fresh, and we always like to look and see how can we adapt and how can we change.
Yeah.
And have a new thing. So there will be a show that will be changing.
Okay.
And it will be becoming this new show that may or may not focus on Guy Fawkes. And then at Halloween we will be introducing a limited run show that is said to be one of the scariest in dungeon history across the board. And I won't say what it is, but I will say to people, bring your Ouija boards with you, because it's going to get pretty freaky.
Oh, very interesting there. So finally, we asked this question last year. I mean, what would you say to people out there? Why should they come to York Dungeon? Why is it such a fantastic experience?
Because if you don't, then you're being soft. No, it's because it offers something for everybody. We're cheeky, we're rascals, we're very in your face. Everybody is welcome to the dungeon. We are a family attraction. I think that's something that people forget sometimes. So it's scary, but it's also funny. Nothing that we do is going to be unsuitable for anybody, say, aged 8 and up. And, you know, we've also got things like our Dungeon Lakes, we've got our Hen and Stag Days, if you're wanting a slightly naughtier experience as well. And there's just a variety of shows, and where else are you going to find this much entertainment within 75 minutes?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, Ben, thank you very much again for
thank you for coming along.
Make sure you check out for the War of the Roses, the Bloody Battle show, running up until February 29th. And, yeah, please come down and check it out.